fenómenos pop más importantes de la década es New Kids on the Block, cinco chavos nacidos en Boston, Massachusetts, cuyo éxito comercial alrededor del mundo es comparado con el éxito que un día causaron los legendarios Beatles. Sin grandes cualidades como músicos, pero con una gran perseverancia, New Kids on the Block, en tan solo 5 años, reciben cartas de admiradoras de todas partes del planeta, superando en volumen a Michael Jackson y George Michael, quienes hasta antes de New Kids tenían el récord mundial en correspondencia de fans. Para lograr este éxito se tienen que sacrificar muchas cosas propias de chavos de su edad. La relación con tu familia y con tus amigos pasa a un segundo plano, y quienes viajan contigo constantemente empiezan a ser parte de tu nueva familia. Las sesiones fotográficas, las entrevistas, los ensayos, los viajes y las grabaciones forman parte de la rutina diaria. Sin embargo, las idas al cine, a centros comerciales, a tu restaurante favorito, a un juego de fútbol con tus amigos, a la playa en el verano o simplemente a comer un helado, son actividades que por el éxito cada vez son más difíciles de disfrutar. Los New Kids on the Block, John, Jordan, Donnie, Danny y Joe, en exclusiva. Step by step, ooh baby, gonna get to you, girl. Step by step.
It seems kind of like it was meant to fall together. I mean, obviously, it was. I mean, if you want the truth, then it sounds kind of ridiculous, but I just think it was destiny.
It's a dream that every kid has to be a celebrity and be a star. And then when the chance came along, it was kind of like a shock. I couldn't believe it.
A lot of people try and say, well, someone's been in it 10 years and 20 years, you haven't paid your dues. But we did it while we were young. The most time when you want to be doing other things, going to play basketball, you know, hanging out with your friends, and we were practicing and trying to do shows and stuff.
To all our fans, I think we're very down to earth, and we want to talk to our fans, and we want to see what they're thinking, and that we never want to be separated from them.
So many kids across the world look up to us and admire us and idolize us, and I think it's a responsibility for us to, you know, preach good messages, and I think it's only fair for us to give them 100% back.